Hi guys, my name is Ferdy and in this video series I will explain all the elements of the free Elementor page builder. In my opinion, the best page builder for WordPress. You can get it through ferdycorp.com/Elementor. You can download it, upload it to your website and learn a ton of stuff about Elementor on this YouTube channel. If you like this video, please like it, and if you are new here, please consider to subscribe for more upcoming WordPress tutorials. And if you can't wait to see what I'm going to tell, then you can go to the description. And there I have the subjects with timestamps, so you can see if you like a certain subject and want to learn more about it. Now let's get started. In this video we will work with columns. I will show you how to have one area with three columns in it, and then again one area. How to make something like this using columns, and how to have two buttons, one at the left, one at the right, using columns. So let's get started. In this video we will take a look at the column element, and maybe you think if I click on add new selection and I select columns, I have columns, I can create a third one or a fourth one, why do I need this? Let me explain it to you. I create a new section with one area and I click over here to edit it. Let me see, I create a background, I use an image. I make it minimum height, something like that. I go back to style, cover, background overlay, a little bit dark, and I change the opacity like that. What I can do now, I can click on the plus, I can add a heading, I can say welcome to London, bring it to the center, make it white, change the typography. Something like that. But if I want to show three different areas where I want to offer some services, I cannot do it. So if I want to add an icon box, I want to give it a background. A little bit padding. Margin. If we want to have three, I cannot do it because this is one column. What I can do is create a new section with three columns, drag it in there, I can close this and this one, duplicate it and duplicate it. But now I cannot bring it up here. I can do that like that using the margin minus, but we can do it a different way using columns like that. So I place a column in a column and I drag an element in that column, and now I can remove this one and I can say duplicate and duplicate, and now we can have three columns in one column. So column is basically a way to show multiple things in a column within a column. And if I want to have a button, for instance, I can have it below again, bring it to the center, say something, Explore London, make it bigger. Now if you take a look, it looks like that. You can use columns to create something like this. Otherwise, you need to play around with all those other settings. So this is the best way to do it. Another example. I add a template. This one. And I want to have a text over here. And I want to place it in the middle. What I can do now. I can use a text editor. I drag it over here in this area, in this column. I can change the text. Make it a lot bigger. Create a background, which is white. Change the padding a bit, 20. And now I want to bring this to the left. So I click over here. So at margin, I uncheck this and off the left, I say minus minus. And now I can bring it to the center. So let's see, minus 200. like that. And at the other hand, I want to increase it. So I have a text over here, 250, 250. But now I want to have a button here below. So I go to the button and I drag it over here. And it looks like that. So now I need to do the same. I need to go to advanced and check this, minus 250, like that. Also here, minus 250. It's a lot of work to all this stuff. So here you also need a column. So let me remove this and remove this. I drag the column over here and I remove one. And now I again drag the text editor over here. And now I can make this white. Then I drag the text editor in it. Now I have white background already. I change the text. Make it bigger. Like that. And now in the column, I go to advanced. Uncheck this and go to the left, minus. And now you see it stays one area. So I say minus 250. And I can change the padding. Like that. But now if I want to add a button, I just can drag it here below. And it's there with the same background. Everything is already at the right place. So that's the big advantage of columns. You can have a column in a column, which gives you more flexibility to add more elements in one area. One more example. I add a template, upload one from elementor.3dcorpus.com, and it's over here, header version 2. And it looks like this. If I want to add a button, I drag it over here. And I can align it in the middle or at the right, but maybe I want to have two buttons over here. So I can say duplicate. But now it is below each other and I want it next to each other. So again, I add a column. So I drag one here at the left and here one at the right. I click over here. I bring it to the left. And now I have two buttons using the column. So if you have more ideas about the column, please let me know. I really like this way of designing using the column elements. And this is the end result. Over here, three columns in one big section. We use columns to make something like this without too much editing and how to have two buttons next to each other. So good luck with making beautiful websites using the column element. In this video, we will take a look at the heading element. This is what we'll make, a header with a link, a different header, and when you hover over it, the background changes. Two different colors in one title. We'll make use of shadows and a different title displayed as a text. So let's get started. So I add a new section and I go for an image in the background. I want to stretch this section. Change the height to, let's see, 700. Like that, I go back to style. And I want to bring the size back to cover. Like that. I go back to all the elements and I drag a heading over here. And I can change the name, Snow World. I don't see that, so I go to style. Make it white. I want it to be over here. So what can I do? I can copy this column. I can remove this. So now it's over here. I click on it. I can add a link to it if I want to. You see, so you can click on it and go to a certain page. I can change the size, but I also can do that at the style. You can change the HTML tag. I like it to be H2. H1 can be used only one time, so if this is an important phrase for your website, then you can say H1 and you can align it at the right, middle, or the left. I like to be at the left. And I can drag this also to the right, so I can place it wherever I want. Then I go to style. I can change the text color. I can make it even a bit transparent, as you see. We can go to typography. We can change the font family to this one. Change the size again. Make it extra bold or really thin. We can make it uppercase or all lowercase. We can make it italic, like that. And we can have it underlined or overlined or something else, line true. I like default. If you have more text, you can change the line height, and here you can change the letter spacing. And the great thing is you see the result immediately. So what I can do, I can duplicate this. And what else can we do? I have some dummy text over here, and then I go to style, make it smaller. I want the text to be open sans. Make it smaller, not too small. People should read it. I change the text color to black. And at advanced, I go to the border. I want it to be a solid border. I'll uncheck this and I say 3 only at the left. And the color can be red. Of course, there needs to be a little bit more padding. So I go to element style, padding, uncheck this. And at the left, I give it some space. Then I go to the background over here and I want to make it white. Make it more transparent. And also an element padding, top should be 10 and the bottom should be 10. So that's what you can do. You can see if the text white is better. I think black is okay. What you also can do if you want to, if you go to advanced and you go to the background, you can also change things when you hover over it. So if I go to hover, I can change the background to an image, for instance. So when I hover over it, it looks like that. Or a different color. And then you have transition duration over here. So let me see, maybe a bit dark blue, something like this. And then a bit more transparent, like that. So two titles over here and you see what's possible. What else can we do? I add a new section and I want to make the background dark. So something like that. I want to stretch the background. Make it a bit higher. Minimum height. And again, I drag a title over here. What I also can do again, I can copy this one. And drag it over here. I bring it to the center. I change the text. And I say Ski Mania. What I want to do now, I want to make one part of the text dark. I have a code for that. You can find that code in the description. And over here, I place my cursor after ski and I paste it. And then I close it like that. Ski Mania. So you also can have a different color within one title. And again, you can change things over here. We can have a text shadow. So if I would make it blue, you can play around with it, blur it more, or more horizontal or vertical. And if I do it here, I should also do it over here. I will leave it for now, for the sake of the tutorial, but that is what you can do with it. You can also duplicate this over here, drag it here down below. And you can adjust it. So I go to style, make the text white, go to advanced, to the background, clear, and hover, clear. I can go to the border, remove it, none, bring it to the center, and I go to typography. The weight should be default over here also. Default. And here I can go to style, typography, and the line height, and I can change that. Update. Let's take a look what you can do with the header. Snow World, a header like this with a border and a hover. Over here with a shadow, different color in the second part of the word, and just a normal text. So play around with that and create beautiful things. And one more thing, this color over here, I like that. Copy and go over here to advanced. The border and change the color to this one. Update, refresh, and this is what we've got. A nice title. You can click on it and go to a link. A title with a hover animation and with this color over here and with a border at the left. Shadow, a different color in the second part of the title, and a normal text over here. In this video, we will take a look at the image element. I can drag it over here if I want to, and I can choose an image. So I click over here, and let me see. I like this one. I insert the media, and there it is, a beautiful image with a small border or gap. So I can go to the section, column gap, no gap. And now there's no gap. I click on the image element. We can change the image size to medium or a thumbnail. If I would say medium, and this is the size I want it to show, then medium is fine, because the file will be smaller. If I would say large, and let me see if I duplicate this, I remove it over here, and I would make it really small like that, then large is a waste of file size, so I could say medium or even thumbnail, and then it will still appear in good quality, and the file size will be smaller. I will use medium large for now. I will make it a bit bigger, like that. We can align it. So if I would bring this more to the right, I can say left, middle, or right. Let me drag it back. And I can also say medium, I think, like that. I can have a caption, woman. I can link it to the media file or to a custom URL. If I would say media file and I click on it, I see it in the lightbox. You can adjust it. So if I go over here to the global settings, then with the tab lightbox, we can turn it on, enabled in the editor. I don't like that, because if you click on it to edit it, it will open. So let me go back, global settings, lightbox. I turn it off in the editor. So if I click on it, it does not open. And now I go to the global settings one more time. The background color, I can change it to blue, change the transparency, and change the user interface color. So let me change to green, gray, update. Now let's take a look. Now it looks like that. The X is green, background is blue, so you can change that. I go back to the image, and I go to style. Here I can determine the percentage of the file. I can make it smaller. I can change the opacity. So if I would have a background image, for instance, you can see it better. You can change opacity like that. If you want to delete the file, you just hover over the image and delete it over here. And there can be an animation when you hover. For instance, shrink, and then it shrinks like that. Then we can have border type, solid, or double, dashed. Let me say double. I can change the width. If I would say 5 pixels, it will have a border of 5 pixels. If I would say 10, it will have 10. I change it to solid, and I can also say I only want to have a border at the left. Then I unlink this, and at the top I say 0, right 0, bottom 0. And now I have only border at the left. I can change the thickness to 5. I can change the color. And you see that color is also a little bit transparent because of this. And now it's really black. We also can have a border radius. So if I would say 20, you see the border like that. And also here you can say at the top 0, right 50, bottom 0, left 0. You can do a lot of things like that. Box shadow. Let me see. You can change it. Change the blur. Change the spread. I bring it back a bit. If we have a caption over here, like woman, we can change everything over there. Make it bigger. Change the font. Change the spacing. But since I don't use it, it does not apply. But I wanted to show you that it was possible. Then we can go to advanced, change the margin, padding, entrance animation. It's not really related to the element because you have all these options everywhere and all the elements. So let me see what we can do. I can have a new section with 4 columns. I duplicate this one and drag it over here. I can go to the section, I say stretch the section and make the content width full width. So if I close this, it will be here totally at the left and here at the right. I can duplicate it again. Like that, I can change the image. Change this one again. Actually, I should align them all. They're not aligned. But if I go over here, I go to column gap. I say no gap. I can say margin top 50 and bottom. Now if I save it and I click over here, it should be aligned. It is not. If I want to remove the gap, I go to the section, layout, no gap. And actually I should make the picture bigger than large. Like that. I don't like this because of the left border and all that style. If you would go to elementor.verdicorpshoek.com, 4 images with a hover, it can look like this. And you can download this example and import it into your website. So that's it for images. You can do a lot of things with it. So good luck with that. In this video, we will take a look at the text editor. I can drag it over here to the right. And you see the text editor is actually the same as the basic WordPress editor. So what is possible with the text editor? Well, first of all, you can place a text over here, and they've done that already. And if I would say enter, I start a new linea. You see, there's a gap over here just because I pressed enter. I can say enter a new title, enter a new linea. And if I would say shift enter, this is the same linea as the line above. Let me explain it. WordPress works with paragraphs. So this is a paragraph, this is a paragraph, this is a paragraph, and those few lines are a paragraph. If I say enter, I start a new linea. If I say shift enter, I start a new line in the same linea or in the same paragraph. If I would select this area and I would say this is heading 2, then all this text becomes a header 2. So if I select this again and I say just a paragraph, then everything will be a paragraph again. So if I click over here, it says a new alinea. If I would say a new title and put my cursor over there and I would say heading 2, guess what? Then this will become a title. But if I click over here and I would say I want only this line to be a title and this to be a linear, and I select it and I do header 2, then everything will be heading 2. Why is that? Because I said shift enter over here. That means it's the same alinea. So one big difference, this is a paragraph. Enter, this is a title. Enter, this is a paragraph. With shift enter, this is the second line of the paragraph. So again, paragraph, title. If I make this a title, then everything is title. So there's everything to do with enter and shift enter. Yes, so I remove this and I paste the text like that, and it just looks boring like that. If I go to a certain blog file, latest news, and I go to this one, you see a title, text, images, Google share, text is in bold, a link, another link, a video. You see, that is not boring. This is boring. So how can we fix this? Let me see. I go over here, and if I want to make it bigger, I can just drag it to the right. And over here, I see this is one alinea. So if I would say heading 2, everything over here will be heading 2. So I say paragraph, and over here I say enter. I go down, bring it back one line. Now those are two different paragraphs. If I click here, I can make it a heading 2. Also here, heading 2, heading 2. Something's going on. So probably, yes, I see there are two enters here, two shift enters. So I need to bring this back and then say enter. And now over here, make it heading 2. You have to play around with it. It becomes more clear the longer you play with it. Also here the same. Enter. Heading 2. This one is correct. So if I say heading 2, this stays paragraph. It looks better already. What else can we do? Over here you see a bar with options. If you click on the most right one, you get even more options. I want to be found by Elementor, so I can select it and make it bold. And also page builder, I think there should be a space over here. Page builder, bold. You can also make it italic. If I select Elementor, I can also change the color. Make it bold, italic, underlined. Put it in quotes. Now this whole alinea is in quotes. You can also say I want this to be a different color. Now it's blue and bold. And if we take a look at this tab over here, the text tab, here you see all the code. So we just select something and give it a color or a quote. But here in the text editor, you see all the codes that comes with it. You don't need to know the codes because we work in the visual editor, but it's a possibility. What else can we do? Over here, I see an alinea and I can align it to the right. So if I would say shift enter halfway the sentence, shift enter, and shift enter one more time. You see, it aligns here at the right. I can bring it to the left. I can bring it to the center. So that's what you can do with it. I can bring it to the left again. And add a lot of themes, you can change this. The look and feel of the heading. Add customize. What else can we do? We can duplicate it. Remove it over here. Duplicate it. Remove this text area. Now if we update it, it's only here at the right. And then here I can place something else in the image. I can drag it like that. So that's what you can do. Let's add a link. So I click over here and I go down demos. I can have a link over here. Demos.elementor.com for instance. And I can change the options. I can let it open in a new tab. Again, demos.elementor.com. Add a link. Or you link options and you can link to a certain page or post. So I can link it to something else, add link. We can add images. So if I click over here and I add media, upload files, select files, I want to import those three images. I click on the first one, hold shift, and the third one, open them, and I want to start with this one. Insert into the post. I remove this column so it will be full width. And now you see it looks like that. So if I update it, it looks a little bit weird. How can we fix that? I click on the image and I say, bring it to the left. Update. That's how you see it. If you want to take a look immediately, then just click over here and you'll see how it will look. You can make it bigger or smaller or align it at the right. You can click over here and link it to the media file itself. Advanced options. Open it in a new tab. You can have caption, replace the image, edit the original image. I click over here, say enter, add media file, select this one. I scroll down over here and I say alignment in the center. Link to the media file and the size will be full size. Insert. Now it will be over the whole width of the website. And then here below, Elementor Pro, enter, add media, and I add this. Now there's the same settings as the last one. Center, media file, full size. Update. And now we have a blog post with a quote area, some style, colors, a link. If you click on it, you go to demos.elementor.com or to a different page in your website, which is still empty. If you click on it, you open it in the lightbox, and that's how it looks. That's what you can do with the text editor. In this video, we will take a look at the video element, and I think this is a great element. There are so many options, so let's dive right into it. I drag it over here, and I have one big video. I want it to take less space, so I duplicated the column, and I delete this one. So let's see. The first option, is it YouTube or Vimeo? And at this moment, I can find my own video, so I search for YouTube for the corpus hook. And I grab this video, copy the link address, make sure you don't have a timestamp at the end, and then this is how it looks. My thumbnail from YouTube, the title, and some other stuff, and the play button. If I play it, you see this stuff. So what are the video options? Autoplay.
Hi guys, my name is Freddy.
It starts playing as soon as the page is loaded. Player control, if I uncheck this, I push play. Now I don't see the bar anymore. Player title and actions. Now it's gone. Like that, you only see YouTube over here. You can mute it so there will be no sound, and you can put it on privacy mode. That means that YouTube does not store information of the viewer unless they view it. So as soon as they click on play, then YouTube will store their information. We can have a different image overlay. Like that. This one. How do we want to show it? Like that, or just post thumbnail. I like it to be full. Do we want to have a play icon? If you turn that off, you only see an image. Do you want to see the video in the lightbox? A lot of options. So if I click on update and I take a look, when I click on it, it opens in the lightbox without any buttons. So I like that. A lot of great options. One more thing, you can say suggested videos. So if I end this video, then you will see different videos that are suggested by YouTube. I remove this one and I drag again video over here. Now I go for Vimeo. You see a Vimeo placeholder, and let's leave it at that. But if you want to, you can go to Vimeo. I grab this one, for instance, copy the link address. If I paste it, it looks like that. I can do autoplay, so it starts playing immediately. I can loop it, so after the video is finished, it will start over again. Intro title, I can turn it off. Portray, turn it off. byline, turn it off. The control colors, right now they are blue. I can make them green, like that, or in the style of the video, red. I can have an image overlay if I want to. But that's not necessary. And again, a lightbox. So if I update it, I click over here, and I see that the lightbox version is not working. I don't know why, but it should. Maybe they will fix that. But those are the options. I really like it. If you click over here, it opens in a lightbox. You don't see the buttons. So there are a lot of possibilities using the video element within Elementor. In this video, I will talk about the button. So I can drag a button over here. And there it is. So let's adjust it. Over here at the content, we can change the type to info or success or danger warning. So you can give it a style immediately. But I never use this because you can style it yourself. I go to default. You can change the text. Go to the page. You can change the link. For instance, you can say go to https://verdicorpuszoek.com. Then you can go to the options. Open in a new window. And add no follow. Or you can just say /blog. So you go to the blog page. You can align it at the left, at the center, and at the right. Or you can justify it, and then it will cover the whole width. I bring it to the center. You can change the size, but also this you can change at style. You can have an icon. So you can take a look over here, but you can also search for it. Arrow, like that. And then you can have the icon positioned before or after the text. You can have spacing between the text and the icon. So that's that. I like it before. Click on style. And now you can style a lot of things. The typography. You can change the font to Verdana. You can change the size. And if you go to the mobile version, you can also change the size. See if it fits like that. The weight, make it really bold, or really thin, or just normal. We can transform it. So if I would say, go to the page, I go to style, typography, I can change it to uppercase or lowercase. I like uppercase. I can make it italic, or have an underline, or overline, or line through, or a different decoration. We can change the line height and make the button bigger. We can also use it in pixels, like that. So you can say I want to have 100 pixels. Letter spacing, you see the button grows with it. And it's all within typography. So I close this by clicking on the icon. And then we have two areas, the normal area, the text color and the background color, and the hover color, and then the animation. So here you can change the colors. The text color can be green, and the background color can be black. So in two clicks, you can change the whole look and feel. Let me show you something. I go to the section settings, stretch the section, give it a minimum height of 200. I go to style, background, and I want it to be a gradient. Like that. Now if I go to the button element and I go to style, to text color, I can say white. And now at the background, I can say make it transparent by this right slider over here. You see? And that's why I use this background. You see the background through the button. And now if I go to hover, when I hover, nothing happens. I can make the text color black, for instance. Make the background color blue. And also a little bit transparent. So when I hover over it, it looks like that. I really don't like it. I make this white. And I can say make it green. Like that. So this is what you can do with hover and with normal. And at hover you can also have an animation. Shrink, for instance. Like that. Or a different one. Pop. I like shrink. So that's what you can do with hover. Change the text color, background color, and give it an animation. If I go back to normal, I can make it look like that. And then we have the border type, and that's what I also like. You can choose a solid border. By default, it is white. You can change it to a different color. And also that color, you can make it transparent. I like white. You can change the border size. If I say 5, it will be 5 everywhere. If I uncheck this, I can say at the top 10, at the right 0, at the bottom 10, at the left 0. So now the bottom looks like that. I can change the border type to double, dotted, dashed, and groove. So if I say solid, for instance, it looks like that. And now I can change the border radius. So if I go arrow up, I increase the radius in pixels. You can also say percentage, and if you do 25% or 50, it will look like that. So you can do a lot of things with it. I bring it back to pixels, and I say 20, and then I make this 3, and 3, 5, like that. And also here, you can say the border radius only should be at the right, and not at the left. Top also 0. So here it is straight, and here it has a radius. So in that way you can play around with all the settings. And then we can have a box shadow. Look at that, you can do so much. I like it. You can make it darker. Change the horizontal position, the vertical position. You can change the blur, the spread of the blur. The shadow can be inside the button or outside the button. If we would say 0, 0, and then just blur and spread, it looks like that. So that's it. You can also duplicate this area, and then you can say bring this one to the right and this one to the left. Or you can say use a column and then drag this one over here and this one over here. Remove this. And then you can use a header over here on top. Bring it to the center. Change the text to white. And then one more thing. If I click on this element, the button here, I go to advanced. To entrance animation, I say fade in from left. I can say slow. And over here, I can say at advanced, fade in from right, slow. And over here, I can say at advanced, do it after a half second. And over here, I can do it after 1 second. And I update it. I take a look. And it looks like that. And if you hover over it, it looks like that. So in that way you can use buttons. So feel free to play around with it. And that was it for now. In this video we will take a look at the divider element. And I built something else. Because you need other items to use the divider. So here's the divider. I drag it over here between the header and the text. And I release it. And here it is, a nice black bar. If I take a look, it looks like that. Goes from the left to the right. So let's adjust it. First, I want to change the weight to 4. So you see it better. You can change the style to double. So you have two lines, or dotted, like that, or dashed. If I would say dotted, and I make the weight bigger, then it becomes bigger. Double and solid. So let me say double, for instance. Then I can change the color over here to white. I can make it transparent or half transparent. And again, I can change the weight. Then I can change the width in percentage, like that, and it goes from left to right. So I can bring it to the center over here. And now I adjust it and it looks like that. But I can also adjust it using pixels. So I can make it exactly 615 or 634. So it aligns like that. And then I can change the gap between the elements above and below. So if I increase it, it looks like that. And if I decrease it, I can bring it closer to each other like that. And if I would go to advanced and I go to margin and I uncheck this, I also can bring it even closer using minus in the margin like that. Update. And you see the animations. So I can go to advanced, entrance, fade in from right, make it slow, and after 1 second. So I say 1,000 over here, 1,000 milliseconds. Update. Let's take a look. Like that. And that is what you can do with the divider. And then we also have the spacer. So if I drag that over here, it is really easy. I can increase the space and I can decrease it. And you can change it for any device. So if I would go to the mobile, I can increase it like that. And also on a tablet. So that's only if you want to create space. But the same thing you can do over here at advanced with margin and padding like this. So maybe you can find a way why you should use it. I don't use it, but I wanted to show you what is possible with it. So that was it about the divider and the spacer. In this video, we will take a look at the Google Maps element. I can add a section, choose two columns, and I can drag Google Maps over here to the left. So what can you do? You can search for Camps Bay, Cape Town, and there it is. This address will not be seen, but it's just for reference. So I type this and now you see that place. You can zoom in like that. You can change the height of the element. And if you go to a mobile, for instance, you can adjust the height like that. And if I update it and I take a look, I cannot scroll, I cannot zoom using my mouse because it's prevented. Prevent scroll. Yes, I say no, update. And now it says on a Mac, when you hold command, you can drag around and you can zoom in with the mouse with scrolling like that. You see some space over here. So also over here, what I can do, I can click over here. And then I can say stretch the section, and the content width should be full width. And then the columns gap should be no gap. Update. Let's take a look. So now there are no gaps anymore and it looks better. You can also click over here and see how it will look. You see it even kind of 3D. Look how beautiful it is. What else? I go back. I go to the desktop view and I can say BDO removed. Update. And now it is like this. And if you don't want this area, then prevent it. Then click on the element or hover over here. Prevent scroll. Update. Now people cannot scroll. So if you want to show your company, for instance, now it's pointing to my house. Now it has an indicator because I use an exact address. I can zoom in like that or zoom out a bit and I can update it. And now it looks like this. You see the house. You cannot zoom or scroll. You don't see the text like that. You need to press command when you want to scroll or zoom. So that's how it works. In this video, we will take a look at the icon element. I can drag it over here and there it appears. I click over here And I can change the view. For instance, I can do default, stacked, then it looks like that, or framed. Actually, I like framed. Then we can change the icon. You can scroll and search for something you like, or you can type something in, arrow or camera. You can click on it and then the icon appears. You can change the shape from circle to a square. You can link it to something, for instance, /portfolio. You can align it at the left, in the center, or at the right. I like it in the center. And then we can go to the style over here. So the primary color, right now it's the color of the website. I can change it to maybe something orange. You see both the icon and the border changes. The secondary color, that's the area over here. Right now it's white. You can change the color. You can go for this color. And then you can change the size. Like that. Make it really big. And you see how big it is? It still is sharp, really sharp. I don't like this color, by the way. I just say white. Make it smaller. Then we can change the padding, the size between the icon and the border. We can rotate it if you want to do that. No animation, but just how you want it to be positioned. Change the border width. Make it thicker or really small. Something like that. And then we have the radius. So we can say 10 pixels. And you see a nice radius over here. You can also do it in percentage. Like that. Then we have the hover. What happens when you hover over the icon? Icon hover, I click on it. The primary color. It can be a little bit darker orange maybe. And the secondary color, which is this white color, you can change it if you want to, but I think it's okay. Maybe something transparent like that. So if you hover over it, it becomes that color. Then we can have a hover, shrink, or push. You can play around. I like grow, like that. And what you can do, you can have multiple buttons like that. Maybe one more. And you can use it in combination with other elements. So if I go for an image below and I choose one, for instance, this one, then I can click over here. I can go to advanced, uncheck this link. And at the top margin, I hold my arrow down on the keyboard. And it goes on top of the icon. So what I can say at advanced, I can say Z index 1. But if I go to the icon and I go to advanced and I say Z index 2, it's here in front. And now you see it when it's transparent, you can see whatever is beneath it. So in that way, you can use an icon. And with a few clicks, if I go to style, you can change the size, you can change the padding, rotate, change the colors. If you go to hover, increase the border. Do something totally different. And that's how easy you can change things. So this is really ugly, but it shows you what you can do with it. In this video, we will take a look at the image box element. We need to scroll down. Then we see a few pro elements. And over here at general elements, we see the image box. I add a new section with three areas, three columns, and I drag the image box over here. And this is how it looks, an image, a heading, and a text. I can search for an image. I have one on my desktop. I click on upload files, select files. I go to the desktop and here I see the first one, a drawing icon. I insert the media and there you see it. Then we see the heading and I can say drawing. And here you can change the text if you want to. You can link it to a certain page. You can change the position like that or like that, but I rather have it in the middle. You can change the title tag. I change it to H2, but we can configure it further at the style tab. The image spacing, the space between the image and the title, and you can change it for different devices. The image size. And I want to bring this back, by the way. and the opacity. You can make it transparent or fully visible. You can have an animation when you hover over it. And then we go to the content. And we can change the spacing between the title and the content. We can change the color of the title. Change the typography of the title, make it bigger for instance. And then we have the description over here. I can change the color and the typography. And all that stuff over here, make it bold. Change it to uppercase. I bring it back to default, but it shows you what you can do. I want to change this like that. Then I want to make the title a little bit bigger. So I go to typography over here and a bit bigger like that. If I update it and I take a look over here by clicking on the eye, it looks like that. And if you hover over it, you see an animation. And when you click on the icon or the title, you go to a certain link you have filled in over here. And now I want to take a look at the column. I go to style. So we are at the style of the column. And I want to add a border. A solid border of 2 pixels. And I can change the color to, for instance, this blue color I have in the title. I can change this to 3 to 4. And I can add a shadow like that. Make it a bit more transparent. Change this to 6x6. And then I can go to advanced, to the padding, and I can say 20. So it's a space within the element. Update. Now it looks like this. And I can go over here to the section settings, advanced, and I can say top and bottom 20 pixels. So there's a bit more space over here. And now I can duplicate it, the column over here, and again. And over here I can remove it. I can change the icon, get a new one, loader. I can change the title to loader. Over here, I upload another one, tools. And the title, tools. But what you see right now is this area. You don't have space between them. So I go to this column, advanced. And I go to margin, but before I unlink it, and right I say 10, and left I say 0, and over here the right one, uncheck, and at the left, 10, like that. So now we have 10 pixels over here and 10 pixels over here, like that. I want to change it to 20. Update. How will it look? How will it look on a tablet? Like that. But on a mobile, it looks a little bit weird. So what can I do? I go over here to the settings of the mobile and I say 10, like that. Also here, 10. And also here, 10. Update. Refresh. Now if I make it smaller, it looks like that. Great. So that's what you can do. And if I bring it back to the desktop version, I can go to the section. I can give it a background gradient. Like that. Or inside a column, I can give it a background. Like that. So that's what you can do with the image box. In this video we will take a look at the icon box. I use this element often in my websites, I really like it. So I add a new section with three columns. I scroll down. And here you find it, the icon box. I drag it over here. And here we can choose an icon. If I want to say something about photography, I can search for photo or for camera. And I can see it over here. I can choose one. Or you can just scroll over here. There are a lot of icons. You see it over here, the camera icon. You can change the view from default to stacked or framed, like that. I like stacked, so I use that one. And the shape, you can change it to a square or a circle. Here's the header. I can say photography, and you can change the text over here. You can link it to a place, so for instance /photography, and then it will go to elementor2018.com/photography. I can let it open in a new window, and I can place the icon at the left, at the right, or in the middle. Here I can change the HTML tag, and I change it to H2. I rather use it for all my titles in my website. Then I go to the style. I can change the primary color, that is this one, and I can change the secondary color, which is the color inside. I clear them both because I like the colors that are the colors of my website. Then we can change the spacing between the title and the icon. We can change the size of the icon and the padding, like that. You can rotate the icon. I do not know why, but you can do it. And let me bring it back a little bit. Like that. You can even change the border radius. If I would say 0, it will be a square. If I say 20, it looks like that. And if I go to percentage, I would say 25 or 50, it will be round. I remove it and still will be round. Then we have the hover. Right now, if we hover over it, we see nothing changing. And I can change the color. So now if I hover over it, it becomes green like that. And you also can change the second color. You can have an animation like that, or just a grow. And then we go to the content, starting with the title. You can change the space between the title and the text. You can change the color of the title. Change the typography, for instance, the font, the size, the weight, you can make it bold or really thin. Make it uppercase. You can change the style, make it italic. You can change the decoration, underline or overline. You can change the line height, but it's the same as changing the space over here between the icon and the title and the title and the text. And we can change the letter spacing like that. Then I go to the description, the color, you can make it black or green. I rather have it a little bit gray, dark gray. And also here we can change a lot of things. For instance, the size, the line height, make it a bit bigger, letter spacing, you can change a lot. So that's it. If we go to advanced, you can say that you want to have a border. So a solid border, for instance, like that, make it 4 pixels. Change the color to this one. Then I go to advanced and I change the padding to 30 or 20, like that. But what you also see, when you hover over it, you can change the border. Over here, I click on hover, change it to solid, and then I can say make it 10. Now if I hover over it, you see it changes like that. I can also say 4 and change the color to green. So I hover over it and it becomes green like that. And if I hover over here, it also becomes green. So that's what you can do. And the transition duration, you can make it slower. So that's it. I can duplicate it one time and the second time. Remove those. I click over here. I can change this one to, let me see, camera, this one. And over here to something with web design. Web. No. Maybe address. And then I can go to content. And I say film. And over here I say web design. And if I hover over it, it looks like that. If I update it and I preview it, it looks like that. And I can make it smaller. And it looks great in my opinion. Then you can go to the section, advanced, 50. Go to the style, to the classic background type, add an image. I go to the section, layout, minimum height. Make it bigger, full width. And then if I go to the column, I go to style, background, and I can make the background white. Also here, style, make it white. Also here, but then it looks a bit weird. If I take a look, we have the background like that, but they're all next to each other. So what I can do, I can go to the column, and also here I can say margin 10. Also over here, 10 and 10. Update, refresh. Now it looks like this. So that's what you can do with the icon box. In this video, we will take a look at the image gallery. We scroll down and over here at general elements, we see the image gallery. And for a free version, it has quite a few options. You don't see that often, a gallery like this for free, but let's take a look. I drag it over here. And the first thing we will do is add a few images. And I'll add a few images with different sizes so I can explain things better. So I start over here and I end over here. I can create a new gallery and I can drag around, change the order or reverse the order. Or you can remove images. I insert the gallery and you will see a result immediately. Now we can change the image size. Right now it's a thumbnail, so there's a lot of space between the images. You can also say full size, but then you will load all the images in full size and it can slow down your website. What you see right now, when you show it in full, you see all the sizes as they are. And I don't like that. If I update this and I take a look, I preview the changes, it looks like that. I don't like that. I want all the images to have the same aspect ratio. So how can I do that? I go to the image size and I can say WooCommerce thumbnail. And now it looks like that. It looks much better in my opinion. And again, if you go over here, you can change the images, insert them, and now they are changed. How many columns do we want to have? Do we want to have 3 or 5? You can change it. I bring it to 4. And where do you want to link when you click on the image? I want to link it to the media file. And I want to use a lightbox. And you can also say the ordering should be random. So if I update it and I take a look, now you see a pyramid over here, but if I refresh it, you see something else. Now we go to the style. Do we want to have spacing between all the images? Yes, you can increase it or decrease it. Update. Let's take a look. Now there's a little bit more space between the images. Do we want to have a border? If you take a look, you see a small border. I really don't know why it is there. You also see it over here. And if you say border solid width is 0 pixels, it's removed over here. But if I update it, I still see it over here. Maybe it has to do with a certain style in my theme. I don't know. But I don't know how to get rid of it. I also can say the color should be white or transparent, but it will not fix it. So if you know a solution to this, please let me know. I use the Flux theme. Maybe there's something to do with that. And we can have a caption. So if we would go to the pictures, you click on one, you can have a caption over here, car, insert into the gallery. And then I go to style, caption, show, text color, black. And then you see it over there. But I don't want it, so I say hide. Update. So it looks nice. We can take a look at the image again. I forgot something. We can have the border radius. So if I would say 10 pixels, you have a nice border radius over here. You can also make the gallery full width. So if I would make my screen smaller like this, I can have it from the left over here to the right over there. How? I go to the section settings, stretch the section, content width, full width, update. And now it looks like that. But I actually don't like it because then there's a lot of space over here, not so much space over there. So command 0, section settings. Stretch the section is okay, but the content width should be boxed. And now we have a nice gallery over here. If you click on an image, you can navigate to it. If you want to change the style within Elementor of the lightbox, then go over here, click on this icon, go to the global settings, lightbox, and the background color, change it to something like that. Let's see, refresh, click over here, and now it looks like that. It looks better in my opinion. So that's what you can do with the image gallery element. In this video, we will take a look at the icon list. So I search for icon list, and there it is. I drag it over here to the new section, and here it is, list item 1, 2, and 3. Let's take a look at the layout. You can change it from a list like that beneath each other to inline. So that's also a possibility. I will choose for the default version. So we can choose an icon and a text. So I click on the first one. I can say I'm 31 years young. I can link it to something. I do not want to do that. And if you want to link it, you can open it in a new window. I close this one. And now I can choose an icon. So maybe I choose for an hourglass. Let me see. Like that. I close it, then I go to the second one. I am married to Anna. Maybe something with a heart. No link. The third one, I see myself as a web designer. Let me search for address. And I can add a new item or I can duplicate the latest one. So I see myself as a photographer, like that. I search for a camera. And mostly, I see myself also as a teacher. I love to teach people about all kinds of things. Maybe something with lecture or graduation, yes. And for the first time, I say it public on the internet, I'm going to be a soon to be dad. Yes, we are pregnant. We're so happy. What goes with that? Hey, this one. Perfect. So we have a list over here. And again, you can put it like that in line or beneath each other. I update it. And right now, it looks like this. Let's design this. I go to style. The space between the icons. I do it like this. I can align them at the left, at the center, and at the right. I prefer left. We can have a divider. And you can change from solid to dotted. Make the weight bigger. Change the color. Change the width. And bring it back to solid. Or just turn it off. I don't want to use it. Then we go to the icon. I think it's a bit small. So I go to the size. I can make it bigger. Like that. We can change the color. To green, for instance. But when people hover over it, they can see it in blue, like that. Then we go to the text. The text color is okay. And when you hover over it, I can also say make it blue, like that. Then the text indent, the space between the icon and the text. Give it some space. And then we can go to the typography. We can change the font, change the size. Maybe I want it to be uppercase, like that. And then I go to the text indent and bring it back a little bit. So I like it, but it can be better. Let me see. It looks like that. What I want to do now, I want to add a background to it. So I go to the section, stretch the section, make the height minimum 800, like that. I go to the style. I choose a background and I go for an image in the background. I have it already over here. I insert the media. Now it looks like that. I scroll down and I go for the size cover. There we are. And the position center right. So I focus on the right area and now we are in the center. But now those colors do not appeal that much. So I click over here again, I go to the style, I go to the icon, and I want the color to be white. Like that. And when you hover over it, it becomes blue. And for the text, the same thing. The text color should be white, and when you hover over it, it should still be white. Like that. Update. Let's take a look. And one more thing. I want the background to be fixed. So I click over here on the section settings. Go to style. And say attachment fixed. Update. And there we have it. I think it looks beautiful. And that's what you can do with the icon list element. In this video we will take a look at the counter element. So I search for counter. And I drag it over here to the section. And it starts counting immediately from 0 until 100. Now let's configure this. If I go to the starting number, you can change it. So you can say start with the number 50. And if I would update it and I preview the changes, it starts with 50. Then we have the ending number. I can say 1000. And now it starts with 50 and it goes to 1000. And you see a comma over here. We'll take a look at that later. Then we have the number prefix. So you can say we have and a space employees. So you can have a text before the number and a text after the number. And then it will look like this. I bring this back to nothing. So it will start with zero. And here we can take a look at the 1000 separator. Right now it's a comma, but you can also change it to a dot or to a space. I like a dot. And then here below you can have a text. And we are still growing. Something like that. Update. So this is what you can do with the counter element. We have 1000 employees and we are still growing. Now we go to the style. I can change the color of this area. I can make it green or gray. And then we can go to typography, change the size, change the font, of course. We can change the weight, make it uppercases. We can change the style, make it italic, for instance. You can do a lot over here. We've gone through this a lot of times already. I like the letter spacing like that. Then I close this and I go to the title. Also there we can change the color and the typography. So I can make this bigger. Also make it uppercase. Make it smaller a bit. And you can also change it for different devices. So if you go to mobile, it looks really weird like this. So you can change it, make it smaller. Also here at the number. So you can change it for all devices, which is great. Line height, maybe you can do something with minus. Then we go to the title, typography. I go to line height. I bring it a bit closer, like that. Update. So now it looks like that. You can also change the time of the animation. So I go to content again. Here at animation duration, you can make it 5000 milliseconds. And in that way, it takes a little bit longer to reach the number 1000. Like that. I like that. What else can we do? I add a new section with 4 columns. And I drag the counter in it. So I search for counter. I drag it over here. And now I start with the number 72. And below I say love shoots. Now I go to advanced. I go to the background. I bring it to white. You don't see anything yet. But if we go to the section, and I would say stretch the section, go to style, go to the background type and make it a gradient and change this to the color blue, like that. Go to advanced and go to the padding and say 100. Unlink this at the right 0 and at the left 0. It will look like this. Update, counter. Now it looks like that. So I go over here again. The duration can be 4 seconds. And it says love shoots. I go to the style. I like the text color and typography of this one. And the title, I want it to be uppercase. So I say transform uppercase. Like that. And make it bold. Now I can duplicate this area, the column, a few times. And I remove this. Remove this. And remove this. And now I say over here, 28 wedding films and 128 websites. And this one, 56 commercials made. So if I update it, I go over here, say margin top, margin bottom, 15. It gives a bit more space. And now if we take a look, we have 1000 employees and we are still growing. 72 love shoots, 28 wedding films, 128 websites. And that's what you can do. If you want to increase the padding over here over the margin, just say 20. Also over here, advanced, 20, 20, the latest one, advanced, padding, 20, update, and that's it. That's what you can do with the counter element. In this video, we are going to take a look at the progress bar. I search for progress, and there it is. In my personal opinion, I'm not a fan of the progress bar because if you say my skill is photography, how do you measure how many percent you are? If you would say 90, does it mean that you're only 10% left of becoming a perfect photographer? And if you say, okay, I have another skill and that is web design. And you would say, okay, I do that a little bit less, that is 80. What does it actually say? I don't know. It seems nice and it looks nice. But I'm not a fan, but if you want to use it, you can use it. I would rather say photography 100%, everything 100%, because if I go for something, I want it to be perfect. But at the same time, I'm not at 100%. There's so much more to learn about photography and web design. Enough of that. Let me just show you how to work with this element. I remove the second one and let me start over. The title. For instance, I love to teach, so I say teaching. I think that's one of my skills. The type, you can change the type, but I rather do not do that because you can change the colors and stuff at the style. So I bring it back to default. At style, you have more freedom to change the look and feel. The percentage. Now, let me say 85. You can do that. Do you want to show the percentage or hide it? I hide it. And then we have the inner text. Here above it says teaching. And here below I can say teaching. But why should I say it twice? So I can remove it over here and then automatically it will disappear, which I really like. So now it looks like this. I go to the style and I can change the color. I can make it green. And I can change the background color, which is this area over here. And I can say it should be black or white or something else. I make it white for now. And then we have the inner text color, which is this color over here. I can change that, but I leave it white. Then we have the title style. Since we do not have a title over here, I can change everything, but it will not be seen. So I leave it. But if I would have a title, teaching, I can style it over here. I can change the text color. I can make it bigger. I can do a lot of things. Make it uppercase, all that stuff. But I don't like it, so I remove it. So we have teaching over here, and it's 90% or 85%. I can duplicate it. And now I can change the background color if I want to this one. This is photography. And I think I changed the background, so that's not what I should do. Like that. Now I can change it. And it looks like that. 80. I go to style. And I go to background color and I say white. One more. Copy it. And say film, for instance. I don't film that much anymore, so I say 70. I can change the color to purple. So it looks like that. And what I like to do now, I like to go to the section, to style, video background, and now I go to YouTube, and I search for GoPro Hero 6. There's a video over here, the second one, right mouse click, copy the link address, paste it over here. Now it looks like that. I go to layout and I say make it stretched and the minimum height of 600. Like that. I update it and I take a look. And now it looks like this. But what you can do, over here you see all those white backgrounds. You can change those. You can make them transparent. So I click over here. I go to style. And the background color, I make it transparent with the right slider. Like that. And now it's transparent. I do the same for the second one. And for the third one. I think that looks much more professional. What you also can do, you click over here, go to advanced, and go to the padding, and you say 20. Also here, advanced, 20. And here, 20. What I don't like is that you can't make this bigger. So it's really small. Update. So now it looks like this. Teaching, okay. Photography, a little bit less. And film, a little bit less. So that is what you can do with the progress bar. In this video, we will take a look at the testimonial element. So I search for testimonial, and there it is. I drag it into the section, and you can edit your text over here. You can choose an image of the one that is giving the testimonial. So I click on the image. And I go for this person. I insert the media. And I can change the text as I said before. I scroll down. Image size is full. What is his name? His name is Daniel Lugo. He is a fitness coach. You can have a link to his website. For instance, https://fitnesscoach.com. You can decide to open it in a new tab, new window. The image position, you can have it at the side of the name or on top of the name. I like it at the side. I can align the text and image to the left or to the right, or just leave it in the middle. I like it in the middle. I go to the style and we can change the text color. I like the color, so I leave it. I can make it bigger, smaller. It's okay like that. You can change the weight, transform it, change the style, change the letter spacing. You can do a lot over here. Then we can go to the image. I can say make it bigger. We can have a border type of the image like that. And then play around with the thickness of the border. You can change the color, but I leave it as it is for now. I go to the name, change the color if you want to. But it does not change because it is a link, and a link on this website has this color. So the link color will override this color. So I cannot change it over here. I can make the name bigger, and I like it to be in upper cases, like that. And the job title can be a bit smaller, like that. Update, let's take a look. And this is how it looks. What you can do, go over here to the section settings, go to advanced and say top and margin 50. So it gives a little bit more space. Now let's take it to the next level. I drag those column widget over here and I go to the settings of the section, not the columns. So I click over here, I stretch the section, I go to style, I create a gradient with the color blue and maybe a lighter blue like that. I want to change the angle like that, and I can drag a header in it here above. Bring it to the middle, say what people say about us. Of course, I go to style, change the text to white. That's it. Now I duplicate this area, this element, and I drag it in the first column. Now we can go to the column settings, and I go to the style and I change the background type to a classic white background like that. And if you hover over it, you can change the color. You can make it a little bit grayish. So if you hover over it, it becomes gray like that. I don't like it, but it's just to illustrate what you can do. What else? If I go to normal, we can go to the border, and I can say I want to have a small border, a solid border with the color blue, like that. 3 pixels. But also here you can select hover, solid, and the width will be 6 pixels. So an increase when you hover over it. So let me see, if I hover over it, you see it changes. So what I can do now, I go to the background again to hover, and I clear it because I don't want to change the color. But what I like, when you hover over it, the thickness changes. What you also can do, border, keep it the same, but when you hover over it, there comes a radius of 10 pixels, like that. Make it 20. Update. And now it looks like that. So that's what you can do. I want to change the text over here. It's a little bit big, I think. So I go to the content, text, typography, and I make it a bit smaller like that. Change the increase a bit more. Padding 30, or 20, like that. Now, if I duplicate this like that and I remove this one, you see there's almost no space between those two testimonials. If I want to get more space over here, I click on the column, go to advanced, margin, uncheck it, and at the right I say 15. And also here, second column, advanced, uncheck, at the left I say 15. Update. Now it looks like that. I want to create a bit more space, so I go to the settings of the section. I go to margin, uncheck, top 20 or 30, and bottom 30. So it gives a bit more space. Also over here, I click here, advanced, padding, uncheck, and the bottom I say 20. So it gives a bit more space everywhere. I like that. I think this looks much better. So if you hover over it, you see a small change, and I like it. And then you go to the second element. You can change the name. So here I can change it to Eliza Dupont. She's an artist, and she has no link to her website. So you see the color changes because it's not a link anymore. And what I want to do now, I want to duplicate this whole area. And then over here, I say, I increase this to 30. So it has a nice square in the middle over here. And then again, I can change it over here, change the image to this one, and the fourth one. And you also can leave the title empty, like that. Update. So you can do something like this, or something like this. So that's what you can do with a testimonial element. In this video, we are going to take a look at the tab element. I really like this element, so let me search for it. Tab, tabs, and I drag it over here. What you see is two tabs. So if you update it and you take a look, you see some information over here. And if you go to the second tab, you see also different information with the same text. So if I would go to tab one and say photography, you can change the text over here, so I can paste it, and that's it. If you want to, you can add an image by adding media, but I don't want that. And here you can make things bold, italic, and all that stuff. If you want to know more about that, then go to the text editor tutorial. I close this, I go to the second one, and that is film. And I paste my text for film, and then I close it, and I add a new item, or I duplicate the latest one, and I call this one web design. I scroll down and I paste my text like that. I update it and I take a look. Now you see photography, film, and web design. So in that way you can display your information in a tab using tabs. But what I want to do now, I want to duplicate this area and remove this one, and I just want to add an image. So like that, I choose the image, this one. So people see who we are, and then they see those tabs over here. Photography, film, web design. But what if I want to change the look and feel? How can I do that? I go to the element and I can change the type from horizontal to vertical. So let me do that. Update. What I see is that photography is not one word. So I can drag this to the left. Or if I bring it back a bit, I go to the element, I go to style, and I say navigation width. And I change it like that. So that's what you can do. You can play around with those settings. The border width, this border over here, you can make it 5 pixels or just 1. And you can change the color. Make it blue, for instance. Let's say 2 pixels. We can have a background. like that, and then it's only this area over here. And then we can change the title. We can change the color of the title, but you can also change the color of the active title. So I can make this one dark, maybe a bit darker, and then you see it's active. I can make it uppercases, but then I need to go back and change this, or I go to the typography and I make it a bit smaller. So that's what you can do. And then we have the content. We can change the color of the content and the typography of the content. So if I update it, it looks like that. Film, web design. If I duplicate this whole area, I can drag this over here. I can drag this element over here. And what I also can say, again, I can make it horizontal like that. Update. So now you see it here, photography, film, and web design with a beautiful border around it. I like it when the color is still the same. So I go to style, active color, clear, update. And now it's blue. So that is what you can do with the tabs element. In this video, we will take a look at the accordion element. I search for it ACC and I drag it over here. It's a bit similar as the tabs element. So let's take a look. I open it and I can change the title. So I can say photography. And I place the text over here. Then I close it. I open the second one and I say film. And I paste it. And then I add a third item, or I can duplicate an item by clicking this icon. I click over here and I say web design. And I paste the text here like that. I scroll up. So if I update it and I take a look by clicking on the eye, it opens with photography. Then we can open film. And when you open film, it closes photography and web design. So you can also use it for frequently asked questions, for instance. So question here and then the answer over here. And if you open a new question, you see the answer over here. And in that way, you can display it really nicely. So what else? The HTML tag, I think H2. It makes it really big, but we can make it smaller later. The icon, you can choose whatever you want. I like the plus, so I leave it as it is. And the active icon, minus. I think that's okay, but you can change it if you want to. I go to the style, to the border width. So you see where it is. You can change the color of the border. I make it smaller. 1 pixel. Then we go to the title. Of course, it should be a bit smaller. So I go to typography. I say, make it smaller, but I like it to be in capitals. And you can change the style, decoration. You can change the letter spacing. Let's take a look over here. We can change the background. So you can make it white and then a bit darker, maybe like that. You can change the color and you can change the active color. So if I would say active color is green and you open something else, that becomes green. But because it's opened, you already know that you're over here. So I leave the color blue. You can change typography. The padding. You can increase the padding like that. I leave it empty. Then we go to the icon. Change the spacing between the icon and the text. Have the alignment of the icon over there. Actually, I like that. You can choose whatever you want. You can change the color of the icon. Do something else. And the active color, like that. Or a happy color, a warm color, like that. And then we go to the content. You can change the background over here. the color of the content and the typography, and also here the padding. I want to align it like that. I think that's okay. You can also change it in percentage, but I think this is perfect. If you duplicate this column, it looks like that. So you can also use it in this way. So if I would duplicate this, and here I would remove this, and here I increase the margin, then you see what we can make with this. Or like that. I like that also. Or like that. So that's what you can do with the accordion element. And then we have the toggle element. So I go to the elements, I search for toggle, I drag it over here, and there's only one difference. And that is, if you click on something else, the first one does not close. If I click on photography and then I click on film, you see photography closes. But if I click on the first one and then on the second one, they stay open. So that's the only difference. Besides that, everything over here is the same. So that's it about the accordion and about the toggle element. In this video, we will take a look at the social icons element. And I really like this element. It has more options than some paid versions. So let's search for social icons. And here it is. I drag it over here. And it comes with three links already. Here you see them. So if I click on Facebook, you can search for the Facebook icon. You can also search for Instagram. And then you can change the link over here. So you can go to Instagram, do your link, copy it, and then paste it over here. And if people click on it, you can decide that they open it in a new window. I suggest you do that. That is better, because then people will also stay on your site. Then we have Twitter. You can go to twitter.com/your link and then paste that code over here. I do this one for now because I don't have Twitter anymore. Google Plus, same story. So if you want to add something new, you can add a new item and you get a WordPress icon. I want to change it. So how can I do that? I search for Facebook and then I can add my Facebook link over here. So what else? Maybe you want to have YouTube. So you put your YouTube link over here. Click on it. What else? Maybe you're a Twitch player, then you can do Twitch. And what you see, they all have their own style of their icon. You can change the shape to square or make it round. You can align them at the left and at the right. And maybe you want to align them in the middle, but on a tablet. So you click over here. You want them align them at the left. Update. Let's take a look. So if I would make the screen smaller, then it will go to the left like that. So that's what you can do with Elementor. It's really great. I want to bring it back to the center. And you can also give it its own style. So I go to style. And right now you see the color is official color. I can also change it to a custom color. So maybe I want to have a blue background with a white icon. You can change the icon over here. The color of the logo. We can change the size. We can change the padding. And also here you can change it for different devices. We can change the spacing. We can have a border. So if I would say 5 pixels and the color is blue, it looks like that. And you can decrease it. If you uncheck this, you can say top 5, right 1, bottom 5, right 1. And then you get a style like that. Maybe for Easter, it looks like an egg. Maybe top will be 6 then. Something like that, or bottom 4. You can do a lot of things with it. And then we have the border radius. Right now it's a square. You can increase it. And also here you can uncheck it and say I only want to have a border at the top. So that's what you can do. And when you hover over it, right now nothing happens, but you can change the color like that, the secondary color, the border color, and with a hover you can make it grow or shrink. So that's what you can do. You can also give it a different background using the section settings, a gradient, change the minimum height to 200, or just default and then go to the section settings and say margin 20, and then go to the padding 20, update. So right now it looks totally different. So if I want to duplicate this, I go over here, I remove the background, and I go to the element, and I go to style, and I say official color, and I change this stuff to nothing, border, none, zero, and then you have something like that. And if you hover over it, it looks like that. So that is what you can do with the social icons element. In this video, we will take a look at the alerts element. So if I search for alerts, I drag it here to the right, and this is it. Take a look. And this is an alert with a cross, and you can remove it. So what I can do, I can change it over here, so it will have a different color. But we can change those colors ourselves, so I never use this. I can say this is a warning. Then I can say when you get, and we can dismiss it, which is really nice. So if I update it and you have some text over here and you do a warning, then you can remove it. So you can decide if you want to show that X or hide it. I like to show it. And then we can go to the style, the background color. You can change it. Make it lighter, make it transparent. And then you can go to the border color, gray, or the color of the website. You can make it thicker or thinner. And then we can go to the title. We can change the text color, make it blue, make it a bit bigger, make it uppercases. And the description, same thing, you can change the text. Make it bigger. And you can change the line height, letter spacing, all that stuff. You can also use it for quotes. So you can say Proverbs 23 verse 7. As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. I really like that scripture. And you can change the style, of course, do a lot of things, make it bigger, bam, description, bigger. And then you think, okay, close it, and close it. And that's what you can do with the alerts element within Elementor. In this video, we will take a look at the SoundCloud element, and I have to say, I'm really impressed with what you can do with it. I search for SoundCloud, and I drag it over here. SoundCloud is a platform where people can show their music and people can embed it to their website. So right now we have embedded this song on our website. If I search for Tony Anderson Music SoundCloud, I had the privilege of talking to this person, Tony Anderson, a really humble guy, which is really gifted for making music. So I definitely suggest you listen to his music. And maybe you like it. And there's one song which I really love. It's this one. So if I click on it, I go to the page about the song, I copy the link, I go to Elementor, and at the link, I change it. And there it is. And you see a lot of other things. You can share it, you can buy it, you see comments over here. But you can adjust a lot within this element. I can change it to a visual player. And then it looks like that. And why not? And then I can do autoplay. And if I update, I take a look. It looks like this. The author, the title, is from SoundCloud. You can buy it, you can share it. You can see the comments. So if I would turn it off, for instance, buy button, it will disappear. Or the like button, download, share, comments, play accounts, username, it will all disappear. I can even change the color over here to a blue color, update. And now it looks like this. I bring it back to the normal player. And then I can make a background, stretch the area, make it a bit dark, something like that. And I say advanced, and I change the padding to 100 in the top and 100 at the bottom. And now it looks like that. And now you can play the song. What you also can do, I can duplicate this area, remove the background, and I can duplicate this. And now I have two songs, and you see it adjusts automatically. So right now we have a big player over here, as you see, and here we have two small players. So in that way, you can fit it in however you want it. So I suggest you listen to the song and enjoy it. So that's what you can do with the SoundCloud element. In this video, we will take a look at the shortcode element. So I search for short, and there it is. Maybe you think, why do we need shortcode? If you go to text editor and drag it over here, and you go to the text tab, then you can also paste code. So if I would paste the code of the contact form, it looks like that. And if I update it, and I take a look, then you see the contact form. But over here, you don't see it. And if you have a big page and you want to see exactly the result that you have in mind, then you need shortcodes. So I close this and I search for short code. I drag it over here. And now if I paste it, you see the menu immediately. I can duplicate it, remove this one. And if I would update it and I take a look, you see exactly the same, of course, with the adjustment. But you also see it over here. And that's what is really handy when it comes to shortcodes. When you add a code over here in the shortcode element, you will see the result immediately. In this video, we will take a look at the HTML element. So I search for HTML. Hypertext markup language, as far as I know. I do not use HTML a lot because I use WordPress, but you can use HTML. I drag it over here, and now I can put some HTML code over here. And when do you want to use it? When it comes to special ways of displaying things. So if I search for HTML code marquee, and I click over here, let me see. You can have scrolling text, and that's an HTML code. So I copy this code, and if I would paste it over here, you see it over here, and then let me see. Here I can change the text. This is the marquee code. And there it goes. Update, and also here, it looks the same. This is something that you cannot do, as far as I know, without HTML code. So that's why you need the HTML element. What else? Best HTML codes 2018. 7 cool HTML effects that anyone can add to their website. So let's take a look. The parallax effect. Maybe something else. Scrollable text box. So you have the code over here. And how will it look like? like this. You have a scroll bar within this area, and that's what you can do with this HTML code. So that's where you can use HTML for. I never use it, but if you want to, you can play around with it and add some HTML code and see what will happen. In this video, I will take a look at the anchor menu. So if I search for anchor, what you can do with this element is that you can link within the same page. So what I want to do, if I click on photography, I want to go to this area within the website. And if I click on videography, I want to go to the area videography within the website. So how can I do that? I drag this menu anchor over here above the title photography. Over here, I need to give it an ID and I call this photography. I click on update. And if I take a look, you don't see that gray area over here, which is a good thing because it's only here to mark this area. So over here, it's called photography. And now if I want to link this button to this area, I need to give it a link over here and it's called hashtag photography. That's it. Update. And now if I click over here, I scroll down to photography. That's how easy it is, and in that way you can create a parallax website using anchor menu elements. So what else? Here I have videography. So I change the link over here to hashtag videography. Now I scroll down. It's already there. I call this videography. Update. And now if I click on videography, I go to videography. Here's another button, get in contact. If I click on it, nothing happens. So I scroll down to the contact form and above it, I drag the anchor like that. And I call this contact. Update. And now at all the buttons, I say hashtag contact. Copy it. Update. Over here, the link will be contact. And over here, the link will be contact. So right now, when I go to photography, I go over here. If I click on videography, I end here. And if I think I like it, I want to get in contact. I click over here and automatically I scroll down. And in that way, you can use the anchor menu element in your website. In this video, we will take a look at the sidebar element. If I go to the blog page and I go to a blog post, I see a sidebar over here with recent posts and with this area over here. If I want to change that, I go over here to widgets and here I see the global primary widget area. I can add something else, for instance, the search widget. So let me see. You see there are a lot of widgets. I click on it and I say global primary widget area. I add the widget and there it is. I can make a title, say search. And that's it. I like it. Save it. And now if I go to a blog page over here, blog, and I go to a blog post, you see the search over here. Recent post and this area. Now if I go to elements, sidebar, and I say edit page, edit with Elementor, I can add a complete sidebar area to my website. So if I would say I have three sections, then I search for sidebar and I drag it over here and I choose a sidebar, which is the global primary widget area. I update it and I take a look. And now I have this area over here. But I also can say I want it to be over here. Update. Now it's here at the left. We can give it the background. Update. And it looks like that. I don't want that, of course. Clear. It just shows you what is possible with this element. You can show a sidebar wherever on your website you want it to be shown. So that is what you can do with the sidebar element. Thank you for watching this video. If you have a question, please leave a comment. If you like the video, please like it. And if you haven't done so, please consider to subscribe to this YouTube channel and turn on the notification icon. And in that way, you'll be notified when I upload a new video. Have a great day, and you will see me the next time. Bye bye.